was his opponent, I'd leave the building. I don't know what to do. To have Rick Steiner in a cage has to be the most dangerous thing I can think of.
But you know, if anybody's up to the task, it's got to be Sting.
Right.
Sting has always been the most courageous man in this sport. I mean, he's proved it year in, year out.
Well, he'll do it all. You know that.
He'll
jump from the ceiling. He'll do whatever he has to do. He's just one tough guy.
And one would think, based on the animosity that was built up on Thursday, that that things are not looking too good for one Rick Steiner here. He and Tank Abbott kind of went at it. And you know, I haven't agreed with all that Rick Steiner's been doing as of late, but I do have to agree with Rick Steiner's attempt to take up for pro wrestlers when Tank Abbott thought it best to run wrestlers down. We all know better than that.
Well, Tank Abbott may be a tough man on his own turf. This is different ground. Let's see what he's got.
But if Tank Abbott can get in close, he can nail you.
But he's got a reputation. Fastest hands in the world.
Here he comes. Tank Abbott's been known as the baddest dude in Ultimate Fighting, while Sting has been known as the Ultimate Wrestler by many, many promoters, fans, publications. Never, ever backed down from a challenge. Has battled back from injuries and has always been the true hero, the true fan favorite. And he's going to go in the cage with an inexperienced referee and a man who will do anything by the name of Rick Steiner.
Lock the door and let's do it.
There's your battleground, and it's good that you could be with us on this live edition of Monday Nitro in the Houston Astrodome. There's the entourage of Tank Abbott, and here we go.
This is going to be good.
See, here's the inexperience. Abbott doesn't even really know how to call the bell here. He just says, get in there and fight.
And that's the way he is. He doesn't need a bell. Just go fight.
There's going to be plenty of bell ringing here. Sting immediately.
Somebody's going to get the bell rung.
Starts on the offense against Rick Steiner. The cage, obviously, a weapon. Ooh, weapon as you can see, but also used to keep guys like a Scott Steiner. Big Papa Pump out. You can just tell, even though the face is painted, it masks some of the emotion that Sting is starting out with abundance of confidence, and he's fearless right now.
Well, he does have the advantage. Steiner's are so tough.
Hey, I like what Abbott's doing. He's just standing back, letting him go at it.
Oh!
Here comes Rick Steiner. Hammering Sting, firing back. Pound for pound, one of the toughest men in any of the one-on-one combat sports you'll find around the world. And look at these kidney punches to Sting.
Well, they're both tough. They're both that tough. And Tank Abbott's just standing back watching.
Doing exactly what I think a good referee should do, because in a cage where there is, as you know, basically no holds barred, anything goes. The only thing a referee should do in a situation like this is count a winner.
His palm.
Is to count a winner. Drop kick. Oh my. The salad days of pro wrestling.
Oh! Nail him. Oh! Nowhere to go. You're trapped.
Boy, it's very apparent to me that Abbott just wanted to stand in there and see what these guys had. He wanted to be up close about it. He called the wrestlers cherries, cherries falling from the sky. And so he's finding out firsthand what it's like. Maybe he's learning a thing or two about what it takes to be successful in a pro wrestling cage.
A lot of cherries have seeds. You can choke on them.
Meanwhile, Sting at the mercy here. Of Rick Steiner in the cage, used as a formidable weapon once again. Countless cage matches I've seen throughout the years in this sport. And each time I see one, fans, I'm amazed over and over again. A newfound amazement, each and every one, and I'm serious, every one, about the brutality, about how much pain these men endure in a cage match.
You know, I'll tell you something. I've been in a lot of cage matches, but every cage match Ivan has been different.
He's not counting
here. He's not counting. He's not doing nothing. He's walking around. That's okay. He's watching. But every cage I've been in or seen or managed or saw, they're different.
Sure they are.
They're all different fights.
And, of course, every wrestler approaches the cage a different way, but they all have one common thing they use in a cage, and that is they use the cage to help them.
But you can't plan for a cage. You'll sit in the dressing room. You'll talk about going into this match. You'll talk with your partner or your manager or whoever about what to do. There's nothing you can do. When that door is shut, it is over. It's survival.
Here comes Sting, mounting his comeback. Standing drop kick. Another one by the Stinger.
Pretty much on the money, huh, Shivani?
You're not kidding, Brink.
Chalk up another.
Can Sting, though, win the match? Does Sting want to win the thing right now? Or does he want Steiner to endure a little bit more?
Well, Steiner's the kind of a guy you can beat on all day long. You never know when he's finished. You never know when he's had enough. And sometimes you can't tell if he's had enough. He'll go all night.
All right, the Stinger.
Oh!
Jumping in midair, and that frog splash of his missed. Knees were up. The Gremlin back up. Picks up Sting. Oh, my goodness. Across the shoulders in a backbreaker type hold. And Sting is going to maybe come out of this with a backslide. Can he get him over?
Well, the tallest man wins in something like this.
Well, the man who drops to his knees first got the leverage.
Sting should drop to his knees right now and jam his head to the mat.
I don't think he wants a backslide. This is like another version of a torture rack or a submission hold. He's just bending the spine of Rick Steiner, pulling back on the pectoralis muscles around the chest and the shoulders and the trapezius. And I don't know, think of another muscle.
Tony, you've been going to medical school, obviously. Or even working at a ball auto body shop.
Side of the head. Sting tries to walk away, but there's no place to go in the confines of the cold steel. Could be. He pulled
him out of the lane. Wait a minute.
He pulled him out of the lane and he nailed Sting. Tank Abbott did. And what do we have here? Is this athletic tape? That's what it is. Tank Abbott waves at Sting.
He doesn't care. He's just walking around.
He attacks Sting.
But look what Steiner's doing right now. He's taping his wrist to the top rope. He's making the man. He can't defend himself.
And Abbott just walked out, shut that cage door, and walked away. He came out to help Rick Steiner.
Did he ever?
And now taped. And at the mercy of Rick Steiner.
His finger's helpless right now.
He cannot go anywhere.
He can go about 3 feet and that's it.
Yeah, he's going to slide 3 feet right up.
And Steiner's got 2 hands, 2 feet. This thing's only got 2 feet. He's no match. And look at Tank Abbott. Could care less. He's applauding the actions of Rick Steiner.
This obviously was all a grand plan. The fans booing Abbott. Abbott having nothing to do with it. They're watching unmercifully as Sting gets hammered.
Sting is helpless, Tony.
You're not kidding, yes. So what happened on Thursday? Was that all the beginning of a big setup? That's the question I want to know.
You can't dress the soul.
As Tank Abbott walks out.